Hey guys, Hugh here from Square Labs. Today I'm going to show you how to update your multi-currency exchange rates automatically with one simple function that we assign to a schedule. So I'll get straight into it because it's a pretty easy one. If we go into our CRM and under company details and currencies, you can have your different currencies that you can use in your CRM. Now you often know that these are the defaulted exchange rates that populate in your deals. And one thing you need to do is go in and update these exchange rates based on whatever they are. This is pretty tedious. And if you've got a bit of a fluctuating rate, you need to do this often, whereas it doesn't allow you, currently it doesn't allow you to automate it. But what I'm going to do is show you how to do that. So first thing we need to do is we're going to use an external API to get this. And what API we're using is just the exchange rate API. We're just going to use the open one. Doesn't need an API key or anything like that. The rates are only updated once per day, which is all we need. And it's as a simple API call where we just put our home currency on the end and we get a return of all of the different exchange rates of the different currencies compared to our base rate. There is 161 different currencies and I'll link this in the notes below so that you can review if your currency is in there. Now to get started, first thing we need to do is create a connection. So go to developer space connections. We're going to create a new one. Go CRM, Zoho OAuth. I'm just going to call this currency connection. And I just need to get currencies read so we can find out the ones that are in our system and the update so we can update the ones in our system. We're going to click create and connect. And then click connect here. We choose production. And then we click accept. And we can see our currency connection there has been successfully connected. Now that it's connected, what we're going to do is we're going to go and create a function. So if we go through to functions, which is under developer space functions, we're going to click new function. We'll call this one auto currency update, and we're going to select the category to be schedule. Inside here we can then just paste in our code, and I'll just quickly talk you through it. We're going to create our required variables. So we've got our currency data map, which I'm going to link a key map value for the ISO, such as USD, CAD, AUD, for example, for that currencies, and I'm going to link it to the currency data we receive so we can get the ID of those currencies. We're going to create a full list of just the ISO values that we've got in our system that we want to get rates for, and then we're going to create an update currency list. So this is the one that we're going to be sending through to our API to update it. First thing, let's get our currencies from our current system. We're going to call this URL. And don't forget to update your domain here if you're from the AU domain. And we're going to get all those currencies and put them to a list. And then for each of those currencies, we're going to find out if the currency has got is base equal to true, we're going to create that as our base currency ISO code. So in this case, it's going to be AUD because I've chosen AUD as my home currency. And if it's not the base and the currency is active, we're going to add that one to our currency ISO list, and we're going to put in that ISO code of that currency. Now you can only update active currencies in here. Next thing we do is we're just going to put our org currency data. We're going to put it as a key map variable. So we're adding the ISO code for that currency and then adding all of the currency data back in. And this will be easy for us to reference later. Next thing we need to do is we need to call the API. So we just put in that URL and we put our base currency ISO code at the end. And that's going to return us our rates. So we've got our base currency rates here. And then we're going to loop through each one of those ISO values in that currency list. And we're going to add it to our new currency update list, which we'll send to the API. And that one accepts the ID of the currency. So we're going to get that currency data, get the ISO one that matches, and then we're going to add that ID. And then we're going to put in the exchange rate. And that exchange rate is going to be that base currency. We're going to get that ISO, round it to 9, because that's the maximum you can do in decimal places. And we're going to put it to a string, because that's how it likes to accept it. Next, we create our parameters, and all we require is currencies, and we put in that currency update currency list. We then just put in a put call to the same one with the parameters that we've put added here, and that's as simple as it is. We then click save, and you can see our function is successfully saved. Now we just need to create the schedule. So if we go to automation, schedules, create our schedule, call this one auto currency update. And I'm going to choose from existing functions and select the one that I had before. Save. And I'm here going to start this from tomorrow. And let's just do it at 1 a.m. This is going to happen every day. There's no need to have it run any more than every day because the API only updates their currency rates once a day. So if you're running it more than once, you are really just wasting your API calls and you're not going to get any change in your data. We're then going to click save, and that's being configured. Now we can just get it to run, and then that will run. And then if I look at the currencies, you can see here we've got some exchange rates. But if I refresh this page, we can see here the exchange rates have been updated for the active ones. But if I disable, for example, Canadian dollars and then turn British pounds on and then run my function or run my schedule again, and then go back to my currencies and refresh, you'll see that we've now got our British pounds have been updated. And that's as simple as it is, guys. Now, when we go into our deals and create a deal, we can see when our currency is AU, it's 1-to-1. But if I select now to USD, we can see here we've got the correct exchange rate as well as to Great British Pounds. And that's it, guys. Hopefully that helps you add a little bit of enhancement to your CRM if you're using multi-currency. Until Zoho creates an automatic exchange rate updater, this is one simple way to do it. You don't also have to pay for a paid extension because I know there are a few of them on the marketplace. Hope that helps, guys. Have a great day.